drinks we'll be making at the moment is egg tempera. Egg tempera is a really old material that has been used by the Renaissance masters for a very, very long time. We used egg tempera before we discovered painting with oil. So it's a tradition of painting really immersed in our history. The way that egg tempera is made is traditionally you just get one egg. Organic is probably best. Free-ranged organic eggs. Ethically produced.
Slave labor free.
The next material is damar varnish. Now, damar varnish is kind of like a resin that you get from a tree that's mixed with kind of turpentine. But essentially, this is the oil. Like, this is the oil component that mixes with the egg. And the final component is water. So the ratios that you have of the egg tempera is, you have one whole egg, the whole thing. Grab the egg and crack it. One-handed, of course.
That's really important.
That's the most important
step. Like one-hand clapping.
From Derby style.
Does it exist?
Depends if you're there to witness it.
Yes. That's the deep philosophical aspect of egg tempera. So the next part is that you look and you measure how much of the jar is filled up by egg. Now you want to kind of get a rough estimate, or you can make it really specific, but you want to eyeball it and see how much that is filled up. You want to add the same amount of damar varnish. So one part egg, one part damar varnish. So probably,
that was really smelly stuff, the damar varnish, yeah?
Yeah, it's pretty smelly. Like the wing, when you get out the egg tempera mixture, it has a very, very particular smell to it. And I actually really like the smell. There's something kind of romantic about the smell of oils.
Yes,
and the
yeah,
when you walk into a studio, you just kind of smell it and you're in this, I don't know, some kind of alchemical lab or, I don't know.
God knows why you'd have that romantic feeling about it.
Okay, so the next step is you want to add the same amount of water. So pretty much the mixture of the egg and the damar varnish, you want to add that same amount of water.
So one part egg, one part damar varnish, and two parts
water. Water. Yeah.
I'm just going to measure how much is there. It's pretty much up to the top.
As you can see, this is a fairly rough estimate.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to be exact. It's just generally, like, so the reason why I'm showing you all of these processes, and especially using the pigment by itself, is that this is just looking at the materials, see how they interact and the properties that they have, and that you can change and modify them yourself to be able to respond more to what you want. So I can add oil paint in there if I want, which will make it a slower drying time. It will have a different characteristic and quality to it. I can use straight up egg without any of the other stuff. I can just get the egg yolk, mix it straight with the pigment, and that will dry in a particular way. But you know, this is the way that the old masters used to make the tempera, and this is what I'm showing you today.
Will that prolong the like the archival quality of the paint?
Yeah, essentially. Well, because acrylic pigments are very new, they've only been out for like 60 or 70 years, we don't know how long they're going to last into the future. Whereas if we look at old masters' paintings from the 13th century, they have remained relatively the same for hundreds of years.
Mm.
So this particular style of painting means that like the effort and energy that you put in now is going to last for countless generations. And also, on a kind of spiritual, metaphysical level, the reason why that we have the egg is that we have two materials that are usually very polar opposite, oil and water, and they don't, you know, fuse together well. The reason that we add the egg in the middle is because of its kind of material and chemical properties. It brings these two polar opposites into kind of synthesis and harmony together. So you have this tension working to kind of, you know, pull itself apart, but the egg, which is the vessel of life, the vessel of potentiality, is drawing those two things together. And in that space, in that kind of that centered stillness space, which is the potential of all life, bringing those two kind of polarities together, then you have this vehicle to express the polarities that are naturally within you, and also that life emerging and unfolding. So, you know, like, it's really interesting to look at the materials themselves and how they have their own qualities and how you respond and resonate to that, particularly. Like before, when we were doing watercolour, how easy it was to kind of flow and make things really easily because the water itself has that property. Whereas with the egg tempera, it's got, like, when we start to use it, you'll see there's kind of polarity and tension, but there's also this kind of harmonising aspect to it. Give it a good shake. Make sure it's all mixed together. And that's the tempera.
Hmm.
That's the tempera mixture. So all of the water and the oil and the egg have all kind of been bound together.
Can you just explain what the word tempera actually means?
I don't actually know what tempera means.
Is it a temper with an E? Like,
T-E-M-P-R-A.
Oh, tempera.
Tempera.
So it doesn't have an E in between the M and the P.
No, temp. No. I think it's, yes, T-E-M-P-R-A.
Mm-hmm.
Egg tempera.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. This is just like, as they started working with eggs, I imagine, because it's a very readily available resource, and then they just kept on adding and exploring, and all these different materials came together until they kind of go, this works really well. You know, let's work with this. And then one teacher taught their apprentice, and that teacher taught their apprentice, and it just kept on, like, that's what the lineage is.
Yeah.
And now some, you know, my teachers have taught me, now I'm teaching.
So it started off with egg and pigment.
Yeah, really. Yeah, and even like more archaic versions of that.
Right.
Like spit and blood.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then before that was the ochre.
Yeah,
just plain ochre on the rock walls.
Yeah. Okay, so next step, we grab the raw pigment, titanium white, and this is the one where it takes a little bit more, like, it's super easy to measure this and make this, but actually making the tempera mixture to a right consistency is a bit more challenging. So you just get the raw pigment. And the thing is that tempera is not limited to just painting with white. You can do the same thing with any of these coloured pigments. You grab a coloured pigment, you make a hole, you make like a mound of it. We get a little bit, we make like a little hole in the middle, and then you grab this tempera mixture. Here's a palette knife. Go in there. Grab a little bit and kind of pour it out into there, into the well. Just kind of, yeah, this is the mixing process. And what you want to do is, you want to make it into a consistency that's kind of like yogurt. Kind of like thick yogurt. That gives it, that gives it enough kind of density and form that it's not wishy-washy, but it's not so dry that it's really, really hard to work with.
Have you the maths, is this actually more cost effective than buying paints and bottles?
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Because you can, you know, like as John was saying before, you know, you can take materials into your own hands.
Yeah.
Like you can go and look around and find ochre,
yeah,
yellow ochre,
cool.
You can crush it up and then just like,
awesome.
Yeah, just with an egg or just with some oil paint, you can
yeah.
mix like hundreds of different colours. And you can make them specifically in the moment while you're painting.
Yeah.
That if you feel like, you know, oh, this, you know, this really needs to work, but I don't actually have that colour, then you can just find a few pigments, mix them together.
Awesome.
Plus, your pigments, when they're not mixed, they last a lot longer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it expensive to buy pure pigment if you're buying it?
Pure pigment would probably be, I think it's about, probably about $30 for something that size.
Mm-hmm.
But like this pigment, I've had this pigment for like 5 years and I hardly ever use it because I only need a tiny little bit of colour here and there because I glaze, because I like I use it instead of just thick blobs of paint. I'm very aware of where it sits. Yeah, Jace, you can finish the video there if you like.
Mm.